I've got like 5 different kinds of cutting boards in my kitchen, but there's one that I want to use every time. It's got like a good groove along the edge to catch all the juices. It goes in the dishwasher so I don't have to do a bunch of cleaning after preparing a whole meal. But I do, you know, consider those other cutting boards when I open the cabinet. I look at them. Maybe I should reach for the wooden one to avoid all of the microplastics. But maybe also that nicks and ridges in a well-loved wooden cutting board harbor tons of bacteria, and I should opt for the glass cutting board all the way in the back of the cabinet. To cut down on my dinner time deliberations, the SciShow team has actually sliced through the research and has compared different cutting board materials. And though the winner isn't clear cut, I know which one I will be using from now on. One of the most popular options for cutting board materials is plastic. Of course it is! Plastic cutting boards are durable. The USDA says they are safe to use, and most of them can go into the dishwasher. But over time, you're going to see that it gets scratched up, and those nicks can release microplastics into the food you are chopping. And of course, you're not going to notice this. Microplastics can be thousands of times thinner than a human hair. The question is, do microplastics affect you enough to switch to team wooden cutting board? So we don't know that much yet about how consuming microplastics can affect your health. But we have some health issues crop up in mice who ate microplastics as part of a diet prepared on plastic cutting boards. I love the thought of the researchers preparing mice dishes on their little cutting boards and being like, gotta use this cutting board for this group of mice. These researchers tested 2 different kinds of plastic cutting boards. Those made from polypropylene, like the stuff in drinking straws, and those made from polyethylene, like the stuff in shampoo bottles. After 12 weeks of this chef-researcher-prepared cuisine, mice who ate a diet that included polypropylene microplastics had some inflammation in their intestines versus the polyethylene microplastics, which seemed to change their gut bacteria. So both kinds of plastic cutting boards had a physiological effect. But you could take that serving of data with a grain of salt, because we don't know yet if humans experience the same effects. Especially because the amount of microplastics that get released when you chop food on a plastic cutting board depends on a lot of things. Like, older plastic cutting boards shed more microplastics than new ones. That same study found that polyethylene cutting boards released more microplastic than polypropylene boards, but the polypropylene microplastics tended to be smaller than the polyethylene ones, and those smaller microplastics might make their way deeper into your body's tissues. So maybe a newer board made of polyethylene could reduce your exposure to microplastics, but there are still other factors. Even the way you chop could affect how many particles get released. In a 2023 study, researchers had 5 different people use polyethylene cutting boards, and despite chopping the exact same number of times on the exact kind of board, the scientists found different amounts of microplastics from each board. On top of that individual variation, what you're chopping also matters. The same study showed that some plastic cutting boards released more microplastics when cutting vegetables than they did if a scientist just cut the board itself. This is my son's dream, to discover that vegetables can maybe be bad for you. Considering that cutting nothing on a cutting board really won't do much toward putting food on the table, scientists have found a workaround, but it is far from perfect. Washing your food extensively after cutting it can get rid of some of the microplastics. It's a whole process. We're not talking about like a quick rinse here. That will not cut it. A 2021 study found that by rinsing meat that had been cut on a plastic cutting board for 3 whole minutes, you could remove most of the microplastics. So that's imperfect for several reasons. A, it's a pain to do every time you dice something, and B, that actually might open you up to some bacterial contamination. Washing meat or poultry can splash bacteria onto other surfaces in your kitchen. If you don't sanitize those surfaces, the bacteria could make you sick. So at this point, we know of some potential issues with plastic cutting boards, but we can't say for sure if they're actually problematic for people. So you don't necessarily need to go throw out your plastic cutting board. Yet. But if you don't want to worry about adding more plastic to your diet, there are some other kinds of cutting boards you could use. And we're gonna get into the research on— whoop, somebody's on the phone. Yeah. It's time for a quick ad break. We'll get to it in a sec.
Thanks to Henson Shaving for supporting this SciShow video. Henson Shaving is shedding the single-use cheap product cycle. Other razors are more focused on trapping you into planned obsolescence than providing the best tool. Their razor has a lifetime warranty and is built to use forever, which is longer than you'll need it for. So by using their razors, you're escaping the trap of planned obsolescence. And they're taking it even further, moving toward zero waste with no plastic in the razor, blades, or packaging. Plus, their razor works with any standard DE blade. Henson razor designs have fewer breakable parts to reduce unnecessary waste. Thanks to their aerospace machining tolerances and fixed geometry, they don't even need springs, pivots, or lubricating strips. You're science people, so you already know why all of that matters for the environment. You can head to hensonshaving.com and use code SciShow to receive 100 blades for free. That's more than 2 years worth. Just make sure all products are in the cart for the code to take effect.
Some people go with glass cutting boards, although of course breaking one of those is a lot more dramatic than when you cut into a plastic cutting board with a little too much force. Ask Skylar, who wrote this video. Apparently the drama is real. But maybe this one is actually worth the risk. One study published in the journal Foodborne Pathogens and Disease showed that Salmonella bacteria did not grow as well on glass as they did on plastic or wood cutting boards. On top of that, glass is a little easier to sanitize. But glass is also really hard, which means it can quickly dull any knives you use, and that's not great for your knife's longevity. It also means that you are more likely to cut yourself while chopping. For a hard cutting board that's a little easier on your knives, you might want to check out one made from bamboo. Bamboo boards don't tend to scratch up that much and don't absorb a lot of moisture, and that makes them more resistant to bacteria. But bamboo stems are also on the thinner side, and sometimes they're not big enough to make a whole cutting board, so manufacturers often make bamboo cutting boards the right size by gluing strips of bamboo together. Depending on how the glue in the boards is arranged, that process can put glue in contact with your food. Now, most cutting boards use food-safe glues that are approved by the FDA. You would think all of them would, but some can release the carcinogen formaldehyde over time. So you might opt for another microplastic-free, durable, safe-for-knives alternative, regular old wood, like a slab, because glued pieces would pose the same risk as bamboo boards. But even those one-piece wooden cutting boards aren't perfect. Wood has tiny pores. If bacteria hide in those pores and make their way back out later, they can contaminate your food. A few studies in the 90s really put the fear of bacteria into would-be wood users. First, in 1994, researchers at the US Food and Drug Administration and their collaborators compared wooden and plastic cutting boards. They found that rinsing plastic cutting boards with water removed more bacteria than rinsing wooden boards did. And they traced it back to some of the bacteria that was left on wood cutting boards surviving inside of the pores. Then, in 1997, another study took that lesson a step further. They found that even if you are careful to wash your wooden cutting board well, you might not get all the bacteria. After hand washing, wooden cutting boards were less clean than plastic. E. coli bacteria occasionally survived a wash on a wooden cutting board and grew into colonies, and some types of E. coli can make you sick. But since those investigations, more studies have been brought to the table, and they provide a bit more nuance. Like, how long bacteria persist depends both on the bacteria and the type of wood used to make the cutting board. In 2023, scientists exposed cutting boards made from different types of wood to Listeria and Salmonella. Both of those bacteria can spread through food and make people sick. Right away, cutting boards made from European beech had less Salmonella on their surfaces than other woods, and boards made from untreated oak had less Listeria on their surfaces. But bacteria growth over time also varies by wood type and bacteria variety. So the relative dangers of bacteria depend on what bacteria may be lurking and what kind of wood shelter you're giving them. Ultimately, having a bunch of hiding places for bacteria seems like it would be a pretty big strike against wood cutting boards. But as it turns out, those pores might not be such a bad thing after all. Other studies suggest that wood might have bacteria-killing properties because of those pores. To understand how that works, you need to know what the pores are doing there in the first place. Remember, wood comes from living trees that need water to survive, so they need to attract and hold on to water from their environment, which scientists describe as being hygroscopic. Even a wooden cutting board can pull in water through its pores and distribute that water throughout itself. But water isn't the only thing along for the ride. When a wooden cutting board soaks up water, bacteria that are on its surface or in the water get sucked up too. So far, this all supports the early ideas that wooden cutting boards harbor bacteria. bacteria deep in their pores. But a few studies suggested a different ending to this story. Researchers proposed that bacteria get trapped inside the wood and eventually die there. In a 2025 paper, scientists put different kinds of bacteria on a wooden cutting board made from sugar maple and a plastic cutting board made from a material called high-density polyethylene, or HDPE. After 2 hours, there was no detectable E. coli on the surface of the sugar maple cutting board. And this was after no cleaning. Eventually, the HDPE cutting board achieved no detectable E. coli too, as its surface dried out, which dried out the bacteria. But it took more than 4 times longer. A quick note, however, this does not mean that you should leave your cutting boards overnight and get to them in the morning, assuming all the bacteria will die on their own. That's just one kind of bacteria on one kind of wood. A type of bacteria that causes staph infections was still present on the sugar maple board after 12 hours, and on the HDPE board after a day. So assuming you want to avoid that bacteria, and also maybe others, you're better off just doing the dishes. When the boards were washed, bacteria couldn't be detected, and no, they didn't come back out of their pores later. So it takes longer for plastic cutting boards to achieve bacteria-killing outcomes like wooden cutting boards if you aren't promptly washing them. But let's cut to the chase. They're not equally bactericidal. In fact, plastic boards are better growth environments for bacteria. A study published in the Journal of Food Protection showed leftover food fostering bacteria growth on a plastic cutting board, but not on a wooden one. These scientists left chicken juice on plastic and wooden cutting boards overnight in humid conditions that kept the boards from drying out. The bacteria on the plastic cutting boards multiplied, but on the wooden cutting boards, there weren't any bacteria left the next day. The wooden boards soaked up the bacteria soup within a few minutes, which makes me feel like that in the ultimate cutting board debate, wood takes the lead no matter how you cut it. The one caveat is that it might depend on what you're using it for, especially if you eat meat. One study found that meat left more bacteria on plastic and glass cutting boards than on wooden ones, but vegetables left more bacteria on wooden cutting boards, so vegetarians might weigh their options differently. If you work at a restaurant, though, the convenience of plastic might be more important. Plastic cutting boards can more readily go through the dishwasher and be good to go again during the dinner time rush. But regardless of which type of cutting board you prefer, there are a few ways of minimizing bacterial contamination and preventing foodborne illness. You could keep separate cutting boards for meat and produce, and wash your cutting board after every use with soap and hot water. Ultimately, cutting boards aren't meant to last forever. If yours has deep cuts or grooves that are hard to get clean, it might be time for a new one. The best cutting board really depends on how you'll use it, and scientists are still doing research to answer open questions about bacteria, microplastics, and newer materials. But in my house, hand washing a wooden cutting board sounds like the best option. I am definitely going to miss throwing a plastic one in the dishwasher, though.